Hi, I'm Bonnie Vallivant, and this is The Country Beat. This week, we come to you from the set of the hit CBC drama series, North of 60. On tonight's show, we'll bring you interviews with Susan Aglukkaq.
A lot of my music is message-based more than sound-based, so we write a song. Depending on the song, we'll create the music around it.
Robbie Robertson.
When you listen to this music, it just kind of goes inside you and you think, this is like medicine somehow. I'll accept this.
Peter Rowan.
Don't take a long time to cross the river. But that's all right, that's all right with me.
I'm just beginning right now to make serious bluegrass records, is what I consider serious bluegrass records. And I don't think I could do it if I hadn't opened my ears to the music of the world.
And Tom Jackson.
But a young wolf howls, and you'll run someday.
I realized that once you were in the arts, that people really didn't care about creed or color.
And videos from Cashton and the Great Western Orchestra. Hi, and welcome to The Country Beat. For this show, we've traveled to southern Alberta, to an area about 60 kilometers west of Calgary. This is the setting for the CBC drama series North of 60, the town of Lynx River, a fictional community in the Northwest Territories. Each week, viewers across Canada and in 10 other countries watch the North of 60 characters as their stories unfold in this northern Canadian community. And throughout the show, you'll meet some of the actors who portray those characters. And we'll look around the town of Lynx River. And starting the show, a video also shot on location in southern Alberta, not too far from where we are right now. Here's Mark Koenig and The Lonesome Kind.
The highway lines beneath his wheels, his soul did love to run. Though a loner's life, he's chosen that all the wind should blow behind his back. I still see those yearning eyes and his home across the tracks. When we were young, he loved those lonesome trains. Desert highways after it rains, he never seemed to settle down. He always liked to drift around, and he's called the lonesome kind, 'cause he had that state of mind, and some think he's blind. Oh, but he's just the lonesome kind. When we were young, he loved those lonesome trains. The highways after it rains. He never seemed to settle down. He always liked to drift around. And he's called the lonesome kind, 'cause he has that state of mind. Some think he's blind, but he's just the lonesome kind. And he seems older and wiser. He has a calm you can't disguise there. You can see the clear blue heavens in his eyes. He's called the lonesome kind, 'cause he has that state of mind. Don't think he's blind, 'cause he's just the lonesome kind.
I overshot my mark. Hi, this is Tina Keeper. You're watching The Country Beat, coming to you from Lynx River on the set of North of 60.
Coming up next, an interview with Tom Jackson.
Also realized along the way from having done a lot.
Give your golfer the Gold Sports Pass. 2-for-1 green fees at 40 courses. 102 rounds of golf for only $39.95. Pays for itself after 2 games. Available at stores like these, or call this toll-free number and wrap up a Gold Sports Pass.
Energy, harmony, strength. Witness the power of Cashton. Coming December 14th, the Jubilee Auditorium. Presented by CBC Television and Radio in Edmonton and the Edmonton Journal. Tickets at Ticketmaster.
Magic Bag is a therapeutic product designed to relieve pain as well as bring you comfort and relaxation. Magic Bag is refrigerated in the freezer or heated in the microwave or conventional oven. Magic Bag is made from 100% natural elements and is applied directly onto skin. Useful to everyone, Magic Bag is an original gift idea for any occasion. Ask for the one and only Magic Bag, available in 2 sizes at all fine pharmacies.
What can you expect from CBC Radio 740 in the morning? You can count on us to give you something to think about, something to talk about, something about Edmonton. More about the things you care about. Edmonton AM, with hosts Lydia Neufeld and John Grant, bring you more than the news. On Edmonton AM, you'll meet the people behind the news. Expect more on Edmonton AM, weekdays 6 to 9 a.m. on CBC Radio 740.
Presenting the Smart Clapper.
How smart can it be?
Clap twice to turn one appliance on or off, 3 times for another. It knows the difference. Plug 2 appliances into the Smart Clapper, then plug it into any outlet. Switch to Away for added security. It turns TV or lights on at the first sound it hears.
Clap on, clap off, clap on, clap off.
The Smart Clapper.
The Smart Clapper is available at Zellers, Kmart, and Eaton's. Makes a great gift.
Watchdog.
What if you're wrong in your diagnosis?
Looking out for Canadians.
How sophisticated is this new breed of car thief?
Bill Paul and Jackie Barron keep a sharp eye on the marketplace. Tuesdays on CBC.
I'm Trish Wood from Fifth Estate.
Do you take any responsibility?
I don't have my files yet.
I know I didn't do it.
I hate to use the word cover-up.
I didn't kill anybody, sir.
The Fifth Estate, Tuesday at 8.
Hi, I'm Dakota House, and this is set in North of 60, and you're watching The Country Beat.
One of the main characters in North of 60 is Tom Jackson. Not only has Tom become one of Canada's most sought-after dramatic actors, he's also one of this country's finest singer-songwriters. Tom's most recent project is an album called No Regrets. And joining me now is Tom Jackson.
Hi.
Congratulations, Tom, on the new album. How has it been received so far?
Well, thanks a lot. It's been received real well by the critics. They've all been very gracious. We can't really tell at this point what the sales are like because we've only been on the market for a little while, but we have a number of releases from the album, including the No Regrets and Few and Far Between and a lot of other strictly country tunes that are going to be released probably in the new year.
Talk about the nature of the songs on the album and what has been acting as a catalyst for your writing lately.
I think the entire album is really a window of 15 years. So there's 15 years of my life that are portrayed in the varying parts of the songs and the varying sections of the album. I think probably the one sole inspiration, if there were one, for the most recent tunes was my association with Tim Thorney. Tim also produced the album, and he and I locked ourselves in a room, I would say last November, and then over a period of months went back to that room and started working on tunes and came up with three or four songs. We actually wrote more than we actually put on the album. And again, No Regrets being one of those tunes is probably the flagship for the album.
As lovers were smoldering sweet grass, stopped only to kiss you and Don, through the smoke rising upwards I saw your face. Nobody knows where we're going. Darkness falls, I will hold you to my chest. Smiled when we parted and cried when we met. She whispered, I hope you have no regrets. I hope you have no regrets. I think I'm falling and I need your. Judge me tomorrow, but love me tonight. No need to cling to your heart. No need to say it will be all right. We're convicted by love from the start. Hold on tight to the gifts that we wear. Let go, though it seems so unfair. Will you draw the bow? Will you braid my hair? She whispered, I hope you have no regrets. I hope you have no regrets. I think I'm falling and I need your. Like a bird of prey, I feel you're restless and I want you to stay. But a young wolf howls and you'll run someday. I'm falling and I need your best.
Tom, it's a beautiful video, and I understand that you directed it also. What do you think inspired you to pursue a career in the arts, and which came first, music or acting?
Well, I think I, someplace along the way, landed a job in radio, and I realized that once you were in the arts, that people really didn't care about creed or color, and that everybody in business seems to be, at least, and this is my own personal opinion, that everybody in the business seems to be very congenial, and it's a very friendly business to be in. So that's sort of what started me. Where I started was as a musician. I had a guitar, I think, when I was 7. I think I was born with one. I can't remember, because I don't remember when I got it, in fact. But I started out as a musician and moved into the theater arts as a producer. And then, I guess, started to learn the arts and moved on further than that.
Have you ever had a chance to incorporate any of your music into North of 60 episodes?
Not in North of 60, but I did a film called The Diviners, whereby I played a character by the name of Jules Tonnier. And Jules was a singer in the bars, and it sort of mirrored my life in a lot of ways. I can't say totally, but in a lot of ways it mirrored my life. So I've had a chance to sing on television in a dramatic role.
I understand that along with all your other talents, you take a great interest in the business side of entertainment. How did you become aware of the importance of the business aspect, or was it always one of your interests?
Well, there's two things. As I mentioned, I was a producer of theater. So I learned the business end then, but I also realized along the way from having done a lot of industrial kind of engagements, like going to conferences and playing those shows that they have after a dinner at the conference, and I realized that there was a fair amount of capital that was involved in it, and I didn't think necessarily that the artists got it all. So I sort of indulged in that and found that there was a living to be made there as well.
Tom, talk about the Huron Carroll benefit concerts.
Huron Carroll is a series of concerts in Calgary and Winnipeg, Vancouver, and Edmonton. And all of the proceeds from those concerts go to the food banks in each one of those cities. And we started out doing the show in Toronto, and it moved to Winnipeg, and last couple of years have been in Calgary, and this year we're expanding to Vancouver and Edmonton.
Well, thank you so much, Tom, for spending some time with us, and good luck on the new album.
Thanks for having me.
Goes to the front and side. That's all you need.
Hi, I'm Gordon Tatusas, and you're watching the Country Beat from the set of North of 60.
I think I can do it.
Next on the Country Beat, so that's an interview with Peter Rowan and the Great Western Orchestra.
We came with the dew to the banks of the river, colder than June, no sign of the sun.
With 6 Grammy nominations and 7 top 10 singles, including He Thinks He'll Keep Her and Passionate Kisses, Come On, Come On was the album you couldn't stop playing. Now, after 2 years, the Mary Chapin Carpenter album you've been waiting for is here, Stones in the Road, featuring the hit single Shut Up and Kiss Me. There's no reason to wait any longer.
Stones in the Road, available at Sam the Record Man.
Old Strathcona invites you to experience the finest.
Scona Billiards is a place where the whole family can have fun. We do not serve alcohol, and we're open 24 hours. Scona Billiards, next to Bubbles Car Wash on White Avenue. At Strathcona TV Audio and Video, you'll find the latest in-home electronics. Home theater brings images and sound to life. Strathcona TV, we sell the best and service the rest. Old Strathcona, a Christmas shopping experience.
The Leather Ranch, where quality and beauty does not have to be expensive. No middleman. The Leather Ranch designs and manufactures exclusive quality leather and suede garments right here in Canada. That means big savings on multi-styles. Whether casual, classic, Western, or high fashion, they have them all, including the largest Western boot collection anywhere at unbelievable prices. They will never be undersold on what they offer. Looking for the best? Shop where they sell the best. The Leather Ranch, West Edmonton Mall, Phase 1, upper level near Eaton's.
Has your child ever wondered how skyscrapers and freeways are built, or what it would be like to drive a bulldozer or work on the high iron? Now they can, with this 2-volume video set, Road Construction and Building Construction.
I want you to show me how to build a freeway!
Well, Digger, you came to the right spot.
Meet Foreman Scott and Digger the Dozer on Volume 1, Road Construction.
A construction site is a fun place to visit. Let me show you around, Digger, and I'll introduce you to some of the people and equipment you'll be learning about.
Learn what real construction workers know about equipment and building on these two 30-minute videotapes.
What are you building this time?
A skyscraper.
How can you build a skyscraper this tall?
Then your child, Digger, and Foreman Scott discover how to build a skyscraper with this second videotape, Building Construction. Over an hour's worth of demolitions, monster dump trucks, pavers, backhoes, cranes, and bulldozers at work with Digger the Dozer and Foreman Scott in this two-video set. Don't miss Building Construction and Road Construction. In stores now.
Ready. Action.
Fine.
Peter Rowan is an artist whose contributions to roots music are second to none. Rowan began his professional career in the early 60s as a member of Bill Monroe's Bluegrass Boys. By the mid-60s, Rowan, a guitarist, singer, and vocalist, was taking his bluegrass roots and combining them with rock-oriented music. In the early 70s, he worked with David Grisman, Vassar Clements, and the Grateful Dead's Jerry Garcia in a group they called Old and In the Way. Their only recording went on to become the biggest selling album in the history of bluegrass. Over the past 20 years, Peter Rowan has also recorded countless solo albums and has had numerous top performers recording his material. But lately, Rowan's musical focus has been on working with his brothers, Chris and Lauren. The trio recently released Tree on a Hill, and the Rowan brothers toured extensively this summer promoting the album. We talked to Peter Rowan before his performance at the Edmonton Folk Music Festival.
Working with Bill Monroe as a bluegrass boy, I remember the morning that we began to write the tune called The Walls of Time. The bus we drove was called the Bluegrass Breakdown, and I remember the old bus had lived up to its name one more time, and we were standing outside of the bus just as the sun was rising over the mountains of eastern Kentucky, and just rising through the purple mist in the valleys looking towards the east, towards eastern Kentucky. That red sun, and this sort of mystical feeling. And when you stand next to Bill Monroe, sometimes you can hear the, well, what he calls the ancient tones. So I was standing there next to Bill, and he turned to me and said, "Listen to this and don't ever forget it." And he sang me the melody that became the tune of The Walls of Time. We began working on the tune together. So the first time I ever co-wrote a song was with Bill Monroe. So that's a fond memory, you know.
Don't take a long time.